ऑफिस है, तो आई विल बी जस्ट कवरिंग द पॉइंट्स अबाउट हाउ टू परफॉर्म द फोकल एंड ग्रिड लेजर एंड व्हेन टू परफॉर्म इट, व्हाट आर द इंडिकेशंस एंड व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट सेटिंग्स वी स्टार्ट विद फॉर द थिकनेस एट लीस्ट. सो द गोल ऑफ अ ट्रीटमेंट इन द मैक्युलर फोटोकॉगुलेशन इज मेनली वी हैव टू सेव द फोटो रिसेप्टर्स एंड आरपी सेल फ्रॉम बीइंग डैमेज्ड सो एज टू प्रिवेंट द विजन. So the photocoagulation, what does it do? It just creates hyperthermia in the RPE cells, and in turn, due to this hyperthermia, there is a production of the chemical mediators that contribute to the resolution of the macular edema, namely the PEDF, without induction of any lethal damage to the surrounding tissue. So focal treatment for leaking macular edema is combined if there is indication on fluorescein angiogram. So the case next question is, when should we plan for the next treatment, the second setting is required or not? If required, that should be considered at least 3 months after the initial setting we have done, if required, detected by the your fluorescein angiography. Otherwise, we should not do before 3 months. And here the papillomacular bundle is only allowed to treat when it is edema is more than 500 micron from the disc and also from the fovea. Within 500 diameter from the center of the macula, we should not treat the papillomacular bundle. So how do we know that we have performed the focal grid laser, it is adequate, it has worked or not? These three few points we can see after 3 months or 4 months of the laser. You will see there is a obliteration of the maculovascular lesions. There is a reduction in the macular edema. There is absorption of the hard exudates and stabilization and improvement in the visual clarity can be seen very nicely if you have done the correct pattern. We have followed the protocols and the settings we have followed. You will get such pictures. Before a laser, you can see a lot of hard exudates are there in the macular area, and after 3 to 4 months, there is a significant decrease in the number of the hard exudates and even the red dots in between the hard exudates. So the physiology about how the macular edema is occurring, there are two types of the macular edema you can notice. One is the focal macular edema due to the focal leakage, and another is the diffuse macular edema. So focal edema is due to the leaking macroaneurysms, and diffuse retinal thickening is caused by generalized breakdown of inner blood retinal barrier, that is leaking macroaneurysms and tear marks and short capillary segments are here. What is happening here, there is a accumulation of the protein in the extracellular compartment that is leading to the increase in oncotic pressure, and this increase in the oncotic pressure creates the it draws the fluid from the retinal capillaries to the inner retina, and the swelling is there due to this encrotification of protein accumulation. So what is the effect, how does this photocoagulation helps in the, how it reduces the macular edema? We have the physiology, like there is improvement in the inner blood retinal barrier function, there is a remodeling of the RP, and there is a better oxygenation, choroidal oxygen basis is improved. When PRP is added to the ischemic area, there is a decreased consumption of the oxygen by the RP and photoreceptor, and thus leading to the reduction of the vascular caliber of the retinal blood vessels, and which promotes the reduction in the diabetic macular edema and thus promoting the neuroprotection. So there are the two important tools which are very important before you proceed with the focal or grid laser, any even the PRP. The first most important is the FFA. It's help you to localize the foveal center, especially in the cases of the macular edema where you are not able to localize the exact location of the fovea, which is very important. Otherwise, the whole vision will be lost if you hit the fovea. And we have to see the FAJ. Do not cross inside the FAJ. So these two very important points that you can be recognized very accurately with the FFA only. And another important things you get from the FFA is leaking area and the retinal thickening. Like here you can see the microorganism with the hair, there is a fuzzy margins in the late phases, a lot of microorganism outside the FAJ here, and multiple microorganisms here also with the leaking in the late phases, which are sometimes missed in the naked eye. We cannot see all the microorganisms. So FFP is a good guide to see all the leaking and non-leaking microorganisms. So another important tool is the OCT. OCT helps you in two ways, gives you the quantitative analysis of the retinal thickness, pre-treatment and post-treatment, and the your follow-up of the laser. You can see like before laser, there were a lot of cystoid spaces, and after 4 months of the laser, there is a significant reduction in the cystoid spaces, and there is improvement in the vision also. So it helps you, you know, follow up, and you can also show to your patients. Here are the few gratings. For the focal length bead laser, we should only give a very light burn, that is only faint white, mild hazy, that is very barely visible, that is blanching of retinal pigment epithelium only. For PRP, you go for the grade 3 and grade 4 laser, there is a dense white or dirty, moderate white. Coagulation should be there for the PRP, but for the focal entry, mild edgy faint white coagulation should be visible only. So different pattern or different technique what we follow for the laser for the macular edema, like grid laser, focal laser, modified grid, that is grid plus focal, and the newer one is the millipulse and the micropulse laser treatment. Now come to see what are the indication and how do we do focal laser. The first thing is the focal leakage at discrete points of retinal hyperfluorescence 500 microns from the macular center, which are causing the hard exudates and retinal thickening. Those leaking points should be considered for the focal leakage. Or within 300 to 500 microns of the leaking macroaneurysm, which are responsible for the heart exudates and retinal thickening, should be considered. Not within the 300 micron. This should be always outside 300 micron. The parameters is spot size should be 50 to 100 micron, which you can adjust with your slit lamp setting. Exposure is 0.1 second or 100 milliseconds. And power, you start with 100 milliwatt. You start with the lower side of the power, where you can see the intensity of the one. Just you must get a whitening that is sufficient to obliterate the microaneurysm and edemas. So before performing on the macular area, you can do one more thing for giving the laser, how to see what amount of whitening you are getting. You just give 2-3 test spots in the nasal quartet before going to the so that will save your high burn. Directly treat all the focal leakage and irma. Location already discussed. We are not able, not required to go beyond the arcade. Just P2 diameter inside the from the center of the macula. All those leaking points. Grid laser. You are performing huge leakages and untreated laser.
Give him 1 minute, Mr. Coordinator, sir.
Chalo, chalo.
Treatment
please give him. Yeah.
Angle is allowed only if it remains more than 500 microns from the center. So parameter here is again the exposure time for the laser on the retina is 0.1 second, spot size 50 to 200 second. You start with the lower setting and gradually you can increase to achieve a light burn. Number of spots will be 100 to 200.
Yeah.
And distance between the two spot lasers will be 1 meter. So all the leakage area have to cover.
यहाँ practice कर रहा है तो हमने सब कुछ रखने
वाला है. Like here we have given the focal laser, you can see in this, and the grid pattern is followed in the grid laser away from the center of the macula, and in the edematous area only. Modified grid again the grid plus focal. The millipulse treatment here, the main advantage of this is that you are giving a very, very light energy. You are inducing There is no induction of the lethal gate filter inside by the RPE cells, selectively absorbed by the RPE cells.
Dr. Vinod, sum up please.
Yes, sir. Here the important is the duration. You are giving for only 10 milliseconds. In grid and focal, you are giving for around 0.1 second, that is 100 milliseconds. Here the duration of laser on the retina is very less, so less destruction is there. So clinical principle is again focal and macular edema not involved in the center. The initial precaution what you should take, that is first your localization of the macula and the fovea should be very accurate to prevent the burn and prevent the and power should be adjusted according to the retinal edema.
Thank you, Dr. Vinod Singh.
Thank you, sir.